Alright, what up? We here with some more Blaze Blue Chrono Phantasm. Y'all wanted... Some of you wanted is this. This is Unlimited Mars, I believe. I don't read Japanese. Basically, what has happened since we first got the game into the trial mode and whatnot, we've learned a lot of things. Number one, I don't like Azriel's English voice. Apparently, Azriel's English voice is actually, Wesker's from Marvel. It's the same dude that did Wesker. And the reason why I don't like him is just because, like, I heard the Japanese first, right? And I love his Japanese voice. Like, it's incredibly intense. It's just, like, a very powerful, strong voice. And it fits the character. Like, the character's just this crazy, like, battle-crazed, super, like, sadistic individual. The voice fits him. But then you switch it over to English, and number one, the dude's speaking so damn quiet, I actually can't even hear him talk. Like, the default sound settings, I cannot hear Azriel talk over the music. I have to turn up the voice sound. I need to turn it up to the maximum volume and able to be able to even hear his voice in the first place. And he's got, like, just like this quiet, sinister vibe to it, which I don't like. It doesn't fit the character. I don't like it. And so, we learned that. The second thing we learned, this is gonna be some bullshit. Y'all gonna see, but I got something I wanted to show you too, and I also have something that I need to look at. But yeah, Unlimited Arakuni is some bullshit. This character is stupid. It's depressing. Like, just watch. Just watch. Once we get there, the loading times of this game are bad. Plus, that's awesome. Like, he just boots a cop off screen. Like, that's right. I just bodied a cop, and now I'm gonna kick him off screen. That's me. I'm Azriel. What up? Oh, fuck! I missed the combo. Oh, that's not good. Oh, that's not good at all! Shit! I tried to do the thing I wanted to show you, and I got hit before I landed and it went through. Oh, God damn it. Is this for real? Oh, I missed the link! I missed the fucking link again. No, I missed the link! I probably wouldn't have killed him off of that. But I could have gotten more damage off of that and not been hit by the reversal. Oh, fuck me! God! No, that shit, alright, am I taking damage? No, I'm not. Okay, well, I took damage after I fucking got hit because I wasn't paying attention. I wasn't sure if, like, oh, god damn it, I wasn't blocking. What is that? The hell did that character just do? I just got perfected because I wasn't paying attention. The one thing I wasn't sure of, his DP is awesome. His DP is fantastic now. I mean, like, at first I wasn't sure because I thought maybe he still, like, took a portion of the damage when he absorbed stuff with armor. I wasn't sure if he didn't also, like, take some damage during that. But now, obviously, I took no damage until I got hit there, so that's awesome. It's very... I don't know whether or not it's safe when he absorbs a projectile. It's definitely not safe if he doesn't absorb a projectile. Like, if you try to use it as a reversal and it doesn't hit, you get blown up easily. But it's very similar to Doctor Strange's counter in Marvel, in that, like, if you don't activate the projectile counter, it's very easy to blow up. But if you do, I think it's safe. Like, I think I get to block after that. But it's hilarious how much it slows down the game when he starts absorbing all that shit Arakuni's throwing on screen. This is gonna be stupid. No, Unlimited Noelle is just rage-inducing. And cross-ups for days. And I'm gonna get shot in the face by a missile. She gets a fucking knockdown off that for some dumbass. God damn it! Oh, god damn it! Oh, oops. Fuck, see? Cross-ups for days. Oh, god damn it! AI blocked. Oh, fuck you! Shit, I missed the link again. What? I just got hit overhead while blocking. Oh, maybe, I mean, I was mashing grab. There was that. But I was blocking. I don't know. God damn it, why did she hop over that? That was not a fucking count, you slut! What?! Fuck! Oh, you... Fine. You wanna match reversals? You wanna match reversals? Let's get blown up. Is this really all actually comboing? For fuck's sake! I hate this game. I hate this shit. Unlimited Noelle is fucking stupid. Invincibility all over the place. She's flying everywhere. Good luck tracking where the hell she's supposed to go. I hate it so much. Alright, we'll try the third one. And then I'll actually show y'all what I've learned with Azrael. I have managed to do a couple of combos with him, at least. But nothing impressive. I missed the fatal counter combo. Damn it. But I'm getting better, and when I went to that thing, I learned a lot, thankfully. You know, I mean, there's a lot of things that I learned just basically about the game. Like, nothing to do with, like, the gameplay or anything. Just, like, things that, like, unlockable stuff I didn't know. That you could not pay for extra colors. But you get, like, an in-game currency you get from playing the stuff. From playing the different modes, and then you can use that to buy more colors. Because I was hella mad at first that there were only 6 colors available. But you can actually get 16. Yes! No! That Link's hard. That Link is hard to do. Oh, fuck. Fuck. I tried to get through it. Oh, what the fuck is this bullshit? Okay, this is just stupid. Ah, too far away. Oh, okay, I'll take it. No! I fucked that up. I should have gotten a lot more than. What the hell? What was that? Oh, you asshole. Dude, seriously, what is that? What? Fuck off. Damn it. I'm missing all my shit. Do it again. There it is. Oh, and then I missed the easy part. Really, dude? Oh, shit. That didn't hit him? Huh. Fuck. It's the follow-up! Oh, no. Dude's an asshole! Oh, come on with that! Shit, am I dead? Oh, that wasn't what I wanted! What the hell? What the hell? What the hell? This dude can go invisible? I hate this game. Fuck you, Unlimited Mars Mode. I hate you so much. Ugh. I've gotten screwed over, actually, a little bit. Like, my execution has gone to shit now because I played the hell out of this mode. This is Abyss Mode. I'll just show you real quick. I won't actually play it because I need to stop playing it. I've gone through all the easy and normal stuff. And so basically, like, you get these power-ups, right? Like, you get more damage, you get a little bit faster in your movement, like, all this shit, you know, the plus 101 power and stuff. So, like, everything is skewed now. Like, everything is wrong. You know, I'm doing, like, 8K per basic combo, all that kind of stuff. It's ridiculous. But anyway, so yeah, as you can actually see here, I have Terumi. I thought I didn't get him because I thought this spot would be where Terumi was since Kaguru's over here. But nope, he was up here. I actually had to make a Japanese PSN account in order to use the code. He looks, I mean, he looks like a really fun character, like a character that I would really enjoy, but I've also heard that he's already, like, him and Hazuma are probably the most overplayed characters in the game right now, so I'm not interested. But I learned a lot about Azrael. A lot about Azrael. I mean, I've gotten better combos with him, obviously. Hopefully I've learned better combos since day one. His 6A attack? Oh my god, it's amazing. I mean, like, it's weird spacing-wise because if you're close enough to the corner, like if you're past the halfway mark on the screen, and you hit them with a counter hit, it'll wall bounce, but if you're not, it won't. But it's upper body, I mean, like, it's fully invincible to everything that isn't a low, as far as I can tell. Like, it's invincible to jump-ins, it's invincible to mid-attacks, like, for instance, if Tager does a 2D, that little, you know, thing where he kind of comes in like a bullet-ish, like from Super Mario. He'll go straight through that. Like, he'll ignore that attack and just blow up Tager. It's an incredibly good move, but it's also hard to confirm off of for the aforementioned reason that sometimes it just doesn't get that wall bound. Damn it! Damn it! Doesn't work from this range, but it gets me closer. That didn't work either. Oh, I missed it! I missed it! I missed it. I mean, obviously, like, I know combos now, and I know, like, basically the general, oops. Fuck, I keep missing that double jump, because you have to jump cancel that. Fine, I'll just do it. Oh, that was too high. That was a bad combo, too. I need to stop doing that, because that was the thing that, like, that's one of the first things that you learn, is that standing B, or, well, I need to get into the habit of using numbers. 5B, 2C, into 6D, like, that's one of the first things you learn, and you can do, so, I mean, we've seen me do it a couple times, where you go into 2B, and then the Rekkas, such a better combo to do the Rekkas in the corner, because you get that D in there somewhere anyway. So I need to stop doing that. And every single time Platinum does, I need to check this. Oh, she didn't do it. What a filthy slut. Damn it! I didn't confirm, and then I didn't even do the move anyway. Did she just command grab me? How dare you? Oh my god. Oh, I missed it again! He has some tricky timing to his combos. Like, his standing, basically his standing B is you have to, like, you can't cancel that right there. But I missed it. It's too far away. Oh, I missed the double jump again. That was weird timing. I mean, Azrael's a really good character. I can already tell, like, I've looked since because I've just seen a few things where, like, hey, this is, you know, like, somebody, like, a top player from Japan. This is his current outlook on what the, you know, the character balancing is going to be and whatnot. And so I looked at some of that, and Azrael is not, like, the top. Like, a lot of people don't consider him. Well, they consider him a contender for top five. But they actually, like, they're pretty solidified that the top four in the game are Taokaka, Lychee, Hazuma, and Valkenheim. And then after that, it's just, like, there's a bunch of other characters that are not really sure about. They're just kind of, like, there. Like, Hakumen, Azrael. There was another one that was, like, really close, but not quite there. I can't remember. Anyway, let's just move along. But, yeah, so, I mean, some people do consider him a top five character. And I can definitely see why. Like, the majority of his buttons are safe. He has that shit, which is, oh my god, so dirty. Oh, I missed it. Doesn't even work! Oops. That's not gonna work. Wait, it might. Oh my, oh, okay, it didn't. He just didn't tech. Yeah, that was way too late. I wanted to. Every time I back throw, I always want an astral off of it. Damn it! So terrible at dashing. Damn it, I tried to do it again! What?! Oh, you motherfucker. Did I really just throw him out of that? Like, he was airborne. He was in the air. Why did I grab him? Apparently the very start of his shit is grabbable. Who knew? But yeah, that's, again, one of my major problems. Movement, being able to dash every single time I want to, I'm like, probably 50% right now. Sometimes I dash, sometimes I don't. And obviously when I end up not dashing, I get blown the fuck up. I like Bullet too. Bullet's hella fun. But people don't think she's very good, which saddens me. Like, see, how was that not a counter? Whoops. Damn it! Damn it! Can you crouch that? Oh, fuck. Fuck! I could've picked that up. Oh god. So much work to do on his links. His links are hard. He has links and I don't like them. I just like hitting buttons and having moves come out that work. Marvel! Oh, fuck off. I blocked. I guess he was still in recovery. Damn it. She's seen that coming. Far away. Oops. Ah! I'm so bad, I need to be completing every combo. Fuck you. How is that not a counter? Damn it. Fuck you. Didn't even combo! Uh oh. Oh no. Oh no. Oh no! That's off, oh, fuck. Didn't say that's right, we just mash. Fuck you. Made perfect. Ah, what the? Yeah, I need to get his dashing down, because I mean, like, the cross-up dashes are so important. Like, that, his mix-up basically comes from, ooh, I get a fatal on Iron Tager every single time this dude presses, every single time, for some reason, he, like, does sledge at the beginning, and I get a counter hit off of it, so let's see if I can't do that fatal counter combo. Shut up! I can't read that, so I don't care. Apologies for any of you that do. He didn't hit a button, fuck you, Tager! Whoops! Whoops! Oh, it doesn't work, really? You can normally, maybe I just missed the timing? I don't know, you can normally link jab off of it. That didn't work. Especially didn't work because, like, it didn't even... The button that I wanted didn't even come out. Shit. But yeah, that blue beat, can't have that. Hit a button, you cunt! Ah! Fuck. What? What? What is happening? Bak! Bak! God damn it, thank you for that. Doesn't work! What am I doing? I don't even know what I'm doing. Oh, fuck you. I stopped hitting buttons. Fucking right. That Ash was hella good. Like, it's really, really... it's very fast. And it's very invincible. And it has a very strong hitbox. A very large hitbox, I should say. Not a strong one. I'm pretty sure that entire pillar that shoots up hits. So, like, if you hit somebody with the pillar, you hit somebody with the astral. Which is awesome. Could be a good anti-air. Ooh, that could be a good anti-Hazama. Like, Hazama just flying in, you're just like, ground pound, fuck you. Because fuck that character. I mean, I'm pretty sure Hazama is going to be my most hated character. Did you just taunt me, you cunt? Oh my god! That scares me. Ooh, I need to work on that. Man, I feel like that's where most of Azrael's mix-up comes from, is going to be putting somebody in the block stun with his incredible normals, and then going either high or low. Because, like, check how fast these are once I stop blocking Jin. That's, like, look how fast those are. You can't react to those. Like, if I just do them... Fuck! Oops, what am I doing? I don't know why I just did that. Because, I mean, the big ones, the big attacks of those are doing either 6D or 3D. Like, that's the ones where he kind of takes a step forward and then goes high or low. Which also isn't really reactable either, because the step forward motion is the same. So the only thing you have to react to is either the low kick or the overhead. And you can't really humanly, like, react to those animations. But you can, however, mash out of them, because that step forward lasts long enough. But that's a risk that you have to take, because you can't just, you know... If you mash, you could get blown up, obviously. I'm gonna do that. Oh, fuck you! I have armor. Can you not follow that up, really? Oh, I missed it. I missed it. Oh, that still worked. Wow. Ooh, anti-airs. Get out of- oh shit. See, once again, that's something that Abyss Mode just fucked me up on, because my back throws in Abyss Mode are doing like 4k damage right now, so I vastly- fuck! I vastly overestimated just how much damage I was going to do. Do your combos, you dumbass! Cannot believe that hit. Shit. How dare you mash out of my shit? Oh, I tried to astral. There it is! See? Hella fast. Caught him out of the recovery of that whiff normal. Hella fast. But Astral's definitely a character that, like, I just said Astral. Obviously his name is Astral now, because we did an Astral with Azrael. He's a character that can do, like, very well off of very basic stuff. Like, obviously, as you saw, he's not doing bad damage off of, like, very basic combos. And then once you get higher up there and start incorporating his drive shit into his combos, his damage skyrockets. Like, he's very reminiscent of... like, the first version of Valkenheim. Very reminiscent of that, except he lacks, like, the absolutely absurd mix-up potential that Valkenhayn has. But he does have the damage potential. Not like 100% of the time, because like I said, he does require the drive points, the weak points on people to do, you know, really good damage. But still, even without them, he still does solid damage, and you get good Oki off of damn near everything he does. And obviously you have that dash mix-up. His dashes defensively are also incredibly good. He's probably the only, one of the only characters in the game. I can't say the only one, because I don't actually know 100%. But his forward dash is invincible too. Like, he's invincible. For the part of the dash that he disappears during, he's invincible. So, like, I've actually dashed through Tager's 2. Again, I'm just using Tager's 2D as an example, because this is all shit I've seen it happen to. I have dashed through Tager's 2D and then blown him up on the other side while he's in whip recovery. That kind of stuff. So, like, he's one of the only characters that if you have him in the corner and he does a regular wake-up, rather than just having to worry about the back dash, you have to worry about the front dash, too. Because he can just get around you, and you can't hit him out of it. You can blow up the beginning, you can blow up the end. There's a very small time frame for recovery at the end of his dashes that you can blow up. But if you don't account for it, he could just dash straight through you and get out of the corner, which is something that not a lot of characters have and is amazing. But then there's also the aforementioned, he has armor on the quarter circle forward D and the quarter circle back D moves. Both of those, there's armor on them, and as you saw me do with that, I need to sit down in train mode and learn like the best available hit confirm off of that move. But where he hits, if they have the weak point, then you can dash, and then pretty much every button you hit after that wall sticks. You get like 5 normals, and every single one of them will wall stick, and then you can do whatever afterwards. And I need to figure out the best combo available for that one, because the combo that they teach you inside of trial mode for that is just doing 4 of those kicks into a distortion, which is not as good of a combo as it. It's not a good combo, not a good ender for it, not good for damage wise, what the potential is available there for. So I need to figure that out. That's something I need to figure out. I also need to figure out, because his both of those, if you hit them when they have the weak point activated, the quarter circle back one obviously activates if they have the low point, the quarter circle forward one activates if they have the high point. And the quarter circle back one, like, launches them hell. It's basically reminiscent of a Marvel launch. And then you can throw out a few normals. And then, like, once you're done with your normals, you'll fall back down. And they'll twirl down with you. Like, as long as you don't go over, I think, again, 5 normals. Then they come twirling back down, and you can do a grounded combo follow-up to it. So I have a lot of hit confirming to learn. Obviously, I dropped hella combos with Azrael there, so I have a lot of work there as well. I need to work on, because there is a lot of timing. There, well, not only timing, like the link between 5B and the 6D. I mean 5B and the 6C. Ha! 5B and the 6C. That's a link that I'm not 100% on yet. Incorporating 3C, that little like kind of diving low kick to the shins, and then you follow that up into 2-2C. That's also another very difficult, very tight link that I need to, you know, get 100% on, so I can utilize that in my combos, because it's actually, I need to utilize that in my block strings too, potentially. I need to test it, because that's another thing that might be mashable out of, but it's safe on block. So that could be good for pressure, potentially. I need to test it. Again, so, and then I have not touched his overdrive. I don't know what happens during his overdrive. Actually, I do know what happens, partially, because I saw, even if you block one of his D attacks, you still get that weak point triggered on you. So I don't know if there's further stuff after that, or whether or not like that's it. That's just, you can get them when they're in block stun. Even if they block the move, it'll activate, and then obviously you still have to hit them with it to get the special effect. I don't know. But all in all, Azrael is a very, very good character, very strong character, and I am happy I chose this homie, because he's everything I could have dreamed for. I need to test Bullet too, because unfortunately Bullet, like, she's not considered a good character, but she looks like a lot of fun, and I understand why. I'll talk about that in another video, because I only got like 10 seconds left. So thank you for watching. Check out the BB vlog. I'll put that in the description. Peace.